You should have a bottle of melatonin in your bedroom and your travel bag, but you should not be taking it every night to help you sleep. Here's why. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of ChrisMasterjohnPhD.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmetails, just tell me what works. And today we're gonna talk about whether you should be taking melatonin to help you sleep. Now, definitely melatonin can help you sleep. Definitely, I shouldn't say definitely, but there's probably not any risk of taking melatonin in terms of developing resistance to it. To my knowledge, there's no evidence for that. But I still don't think that you should be taking melatonin every night to help you sleep, and there's two reasons for that. First of all, you shouldn't need to take melatonin every night. You should be making your own. And if you have to take melatonin every night to sleep, you have not fixed your sleeping problems. And I'm not saying that you shouldn't take it when you need it when you're on the way. I'm just saying that you shouldn't think that you fixed your sleeping problems because you can get away with taking melatonin to help you sleep. You are on the journey towards fixing your sleeping problems, but the very fact that you have to take melatonin every night means you haven't quite gotten to your destination yet. I spent years with chronic insomnia, and there was a very long time where I was taking melatonin, time-release melatonin every night, and I couldn't sleep without it. I couldn't sleep with the melatonin that wasn't time-release either. And I regard it as a sign of success of fixing my sleeping problems that I never need to take melatonin. I haven't taken melatonin for years, with the very small exception of specific times where I was trying to readjust my circadian rhythm while traveling. But I've never taken melatonin in the context of my normal life because I couldn't sleep in the last probably at least 3 years or so, I think. So you don't want to be taking it simply because if you're taking it, you have not fixed your problems yet. But the second thing is, take a look at the graph of the normal circadian melatonin rhythm that's on the screen now. As you can see, the melatonin starts rising gradually after 6 p.m. And granted, this is going to vary depending on your light-dark cycle, your individual rhythm, and so on. But in this example, the melatonin is gradually rising after 6 p.m. And even by 12 midnight, it is almost going to double to hit its peak between 2 and 4 a.m. And then it's going to fall gradually over the course of hours. There is no way you can possibly replicate this with taking melatonin supplements. If you take regular, plain, immediate-release melatonin, you are going to hit peak levels about an hour after you took it, and those levels will be cut in half in less than an hour. It'll be completely gone in 4 or 5 hours. And that pattern just doesn't follow the natural pattern of going slowly up over the course of the first 6 hours, staying at a pretty high peak for 2 hours, and then taking another 6 hours to bottom out. Now, you could take time-release melatonin, and in that case, you're not going to get this quick in, quick out, but you're going to get this sustained pumping over time that also isn't going to look like the natural rhythm. The closest thing you can get to the natural rhythm is going to be to take a dual action formula, and I'll link to one in the description of this episode, but one that has a combination of immediate release and time release so that it kind of mimics the natural rhythm as closely as possible. That would be your best option. The downside is that with time-release melatonin, some people will feel groggy in the morning because it doesn't shut off the way it should. In your natural rhythm, the melatonin is shut off swiftly by exposure to blue light in the morning, and you don't have that control when the melatonin is sitting in your gut waiting to be slowly released into your system. If you're just breaking down the time release barrier a little bit more slowly than someone else might, then you're feeding melatonin into the system after the natural light rhythm would have turned it off entirely. So, from my perspective, yes, you can use melatonin as a band-aid to help you sleep. And if you do, you should use the dual action formula, and I'll link to one in the description of this episode. But it should be a goal to get onto your own natural melatonin rhythm. It is not a destination to be on even the dual action melatonin, because you want your body to work naturally the way it should, and you want that melatonin rhythm not to be the closest approximation you can get with a fancy supplement, but the actual real thing. I do think that melatonin can be super useful when you are switching time zones. And so if you want to carry it in your travel bag for that purpose, and if you want to have it in your bedroom as a backup or as a Band-Aid, then definitely have melatonin for those reasons. But just always keep your eyes on the prize of getting to the natural rhythm over time.
This episode is brought to you by Ancestral Supplements Grass-Fed Beef Brain. Our Native American ancestors believed that eating the organs from a healthy animal would support the health of the corresponding organ of the individual. Ancestral Supplements has a nose-to-tail product line of grass-fed liver, organs, bone marrow, brain, and more, all in the convenience of a capsule. For more information or to buy any of their products, go to ancestralsupplements.com. This episode is brought to you by Ample. Ample is a meal in a bottle that takes a total of 2 minutes to prepare, consume, and clean up. It provides a balance of fat, protein, and carbs, plus all the vitamins and minerals you need in a single meal, all from a blend of natural ingredients. It's available in original, vegan, and keto versions, portioned as either 400 or 600 calories per meal. I'm an advisor to Ample, and I use it to save time when I'm working on major projects on a tight schedule. It keeps my brain going while I power through the day, never letting food prep get in the way of my productivity. Head to amplemeal.com and enter the promo code CHRIS15 at checkout for a 15% discount off your first order. The audio of this episode was enhanced and post-processed by Bob Devodian of Torian Mixing. You can find more of his work at torianonlinemixing.com. For ad-free versions of these episodes with transcripts that you can read and getting early access to the episodes, often weeks or maybe even months ahead of time, you can sign up for the CMJ MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code LITE10 to get 10% lifetime discount.
All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.